بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى. وبعد،
We will be talking about the story of Musa عليه السلام.
A very, very important messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we turn the pages of the Quran, we will find that the bulk of the verses in the Quran that discuss prophets and the messengers that were sent discuss the prophet Moses, may peace be upon him, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. He is the only messenger discussed in the Quran in so many different stages of his life.
And Musa, he's been described as Kalimullah. Musa used to speak to Allah constantly.
Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in the hadith, he said that, "O my companions, if you want to know the appearance of Musa, then he was a man who was not very fair in complexion. He was one who had very thick hair, and he was not very thin. He had a heavy build about him."
And the story of Musa alayhi salam is divided to two phases. The first phase is Musa and Fir'aun. The second phase is the story of Musa and Bani Israel. The story of Yusuf alayhi salam prepares that platform for all the prophets after Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam is the son of Ya'qub. So Ya'qub had two names. He had Ya'qub and he had Israel. Ya'qub alayhi salam had 12 children. And those 12 children are the children of Israel, the children of Ya'qub alayhi salam. And that's why those 12 children are named as to be Bani Israel, the children of Israel. Ya'qub alayhi salam lived in Palestine, and Yusuf alayhi salam, as his brothers plotted against him, he was taken by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Egypt, to grow up in Egypt, and then to become the strongest man in Egypt. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to unite Yusuf alayhi salam with his other family members, with his other 11 brothers and his mother and father in Egypt. And that's where the nation of Bani Israel begins. There were only 86 members. And then from those 12 brothers, the nation of Bani Israel will increase and increase and increase until the time of Musa alayhi salam, which you're talking about 4 to 5 generation gap, there were 600,000 Bani Israel.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the tyrant of the time. The one who used to say, "Ana rabbukumul a'la," I am your God. I am the highest deity that you could ever have. This was the statement of the Pharaoh.
Ta-seem-meem. Tilka ayatul kitabil mubin. نتلو عليك من نبأ موسى وفرعون بالحق.
These are the verses of the book, very clear cut. We are going to relate unto you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the story of Moses and Pharaoh with truth.
إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا.
Indeed, Fir'aun, he was very haughty on earth. He thought himself to be something very high and very great. He made the people on the land different groups. So he was right at the top. Then he had his chiefs. And then there were those who served him, who were worried about what they would earn if they could benefit him in one way or another. Thereafter, he had other categories. There were those who worshipped him, whom he enslaved. And then he had those who were slaves who did not worship him, but they were slaves, and they knew that this one is not our God. They were part of Banu Israel, the children of Ya'qub.
And Bani Israel weren't small number, a few thousands. There were 600,000 of them. And the Egyptians, no doubt, outnumbered Bani Israel by many times. Fir'aun alone, he had an army that exceeds 1.5 million soldiers. One night, this tyrant Pharaoh will see an amazing dream. He will see a fire coming from Beit al-Maqdis, Jerusalem, Palestine, coming towards Egypt, burning every single house in Egypt except the Bani Israel or the Israeli houses. And then the Pharaoh wake up so scared, And he felt that this dream has an interpretation. So he went and asked his fortune tellers, he went and asked the magicians around him, and they interpret that dream as to be that there will be a new baby born from Bani Israel who will be born very soon. Your ending will come on his hands. And what did he do? He came up with a law that any new baby that's born from Bani Israel and that is it's a male, kill him. So he sent out his troops, his soldiers, killing every single child that's born from Bani Israel if it's a male.
And it is reported this happened every alternate year, because this is how he was informed. He used to slaughter their boys. A little boy was born, cut and thrown out. And he used to allow the little girls to live.
وَنُرِيدُ أَن نَّمُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَئِمَّةً وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِثِينَ.
We wanted to give our favor to these who were downtrodden and make them a'imma and leaders, bring them up and let them inherit whatever came from this particular side.
وَنُمَكِّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَحْذَرُونَ.
And we want to establish them on earth. And we want to show Fir'aun and Haman and the others, the cronies that he had with him, that they would actually lose what they feared most.
The mother of Musa alayhi salam was pregnant. She isolated herself from everyone and she stayed at home. And then months will go past, and then it came to the time in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted her to give birth. And here she gives birth to a baby boy.
وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ فَأَلْقِيهِ فِي الْيَمِّ وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي إِنَّا رَادُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ وَجَاعِلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ.
Allah says, we inspired the mother of Musa alayhi salam. Breastfeed the child. When you fear, then place the child in the river in a little box. Don't worry and don't be sad. We will indeed return him to you, and we will make him from amongst those whom we will send with a message.
So she put him in that basket and she casted this basket in the middle of the river, and the river took him. And the mother of Musa was so afraid on her son that she told her daughter, follow this basket and see where this basket will land. And who is the mother of Musa running away from? Who is she trying to hide her son from? From the Pharaoh. So where did the basket land? It landed in front of the palace of the Pharaoh.
فَالْتَقَطَهُ آلُ فِرْعَوْنَ لِيَكُونَ لَهُمْ عَدُوًّا وَحَزَنًا.
It was picked up by the wife of Fir'aun without knowing that this is going to be a point and a source of enmity and sadness for the Pharaoh.
And from his looks, he looks like Bani Israel. And when she saw this child coming out of nowhere, she felt that this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وقالت امرأة فرعون قرة عين لي ولك لا تقتلوه عسى أن ينفعنا أو نتخذه ولدا.
The wife of Fir'aun says, oh, this is the coolness of my eyes and yours. Look, a child, as though it's God sent. We don't have children. Maybe we will be able to benefit from this child and even consider him our own son.
So what did the Pharaoh say? He said, he is a delight and happiness for you, not for me. I'm sending my soldiers around to kill these kids, and now it's coming to live inside my palace. There is a narration that's been mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if he said yes for me and you, Allah Azza wa Jalla would have not made the ending of the Pharaoh on the child's hand. But child. This is a baby. It needs to breastfeed. So what did the wife of Fir'aun do? She called upon all the breastfeeding women back then. Breastfeeding women used to hire themselves for breastfeeding the child and get money in return because of poverty, of course. So many of the breastfeeding women came to the palace saying, you know, this is the son or the child of the Pharaoh. We'll breastfeed him and get a lot of money. So many of them came to the palace of the Pharaoh trying to breastfeed Musa. Allah Azza wa said, and we forbade Musa alayhi salam from suckling on any breast. Why? Because Allah wants to fulfill His promise to His mother. She sent out Musa to the market and asking anyone in public who could breastfeed this child. This child's gonna die from hunger and he's not accepting any breast. Who heard that? His sister.
She says, hang on, I know someone who is such a good mother. She will breastfeed in such a way that this child will definitely drink. They said, no, bring her straight away, bring her. Look how Allah's plan is. Allah told his mother, don't worry, put him down. We're going to return him to you very soon. He'll come back, don't worry.
The heart of the mother of Musa has been so empty. She was going to go out and start screaming in front of everyone, my son. She's going to disclose her secret that she's been hiding for many months. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we grabbed onto her heart. We made her firm. We made her strong. Why? So she could become from among the believers.
Moments had to pass. She was there in the palace and she sat and he began to suck. They were shocked. So Fir'aun is asking her, how is he suckling from you? Who are you? Now, she didn't want to lie. And at the same time, had she told the truth, it was the end of all of them. So she says, look, I have some very sweet milk and no child has ever refused my breast.
فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنْ وَلِتَعْلَمَ أَنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ.
We returned him to his mother in order to for him to be the coolness of her eyes. And so that she would not be sad, and so that she would know that the promise of Allah is definitely true. She was escorted. She was being looked after. They were all being nourished. They were all being fed. Everything free of charge on the house, so to speak. Everything. And Fir'aun, he's excited because the wife is carrying the baby and she's smiling and so happy. And he's just happy to see her happy.
And Musa alayhi salam will grow. And he grows a very healthy growth, very strong, very tough. That Musa alayhi salam had the strength of 10 men.
وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَاسْتَوَى آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ.
He got to a certain peak and Allah says, we granted him the ability to distinguish between what is right and wrong, that wisdom, that authority, that understanding and knowledge as well over and above that. And Allah says, this is how we recompense those who do good. And Musa alayhi salam himself, being young, he had grown up firmly believing in his heart that this man here is not God and he's not even a part of God and he is nothing but a normal human being. And he was intact within. He already knew who he was. He knew his true identity and he always worshipped the one and only creator.
ودخل المدينة على حين غفلة من أهلها فوجد فيها رجلين يقتتلان.
He entered the city. He went at a time when everyone was resting. Reported in the afternoon when they were resting, he came out. And he noticed two people fighting.
هذا من شيعته وهذا من عدوه.
This was from Banu Israel, the one, and the other one was from the people of Fir'aun, who considered Fir'aun a god and so on.
فَوَكَزَهُ مُوسَى فَقَضَى عَلَيْهِ.
Allahu Akbar. Musa alayhi salam went a little bit further and gave this man one blow. And this man was dead. He died. Imagine one blow. Look at how powerful this man must have been. He did not intend to do anything more than fixing this man and trying to teach him a lesson. Hey, don't mess. But this went beyond what he had intended and it was unintentional completely. As soon as he saw this man drop dead, He says, هذا من عمل الشيطان إنه عدو مضل مبين. This is from Shaytan's handiwork. The devil has done this. He leads astray. Clearly, he is an outright enemy.
Musa alayhi salam hid himself. Now if they know, I did that, it's enough that I had a grudge. I haven't been for the last 18 years knowing that I'm from Bani Israel living in the house and the palace of the Pharaoh. They're just waiting for something like this to happen. Especially the Pharaoh himself, he hates him, but he was forced to keep him there. So he's waiting for some wrong, for such a wrong that happened, for this to make the Pharaoh kill him or get rid of him. He said, oh my Lord, I had wronged myself. I had done something wrong. So forgive me. And Allah Azza wa said, Allah had forgiven him. He is the most forgiving, the most merciful. And he said, ya Allah, this gift that you had given me, I would never use it for what displeases you, oh my Lord. But now, Allah had forgiven him. But in Egypt, if they know he's the one that killed the Egyptian, then there'll be a great retaliation. And then the next day, same time, while he was walking, he saw the same Israeli that he stood by yesterday, fighting against another Egyptian. When Musa looked at the Israeli, he said, indeed, you are misguided, and you are hot-headed.
فَلَمَّا أَرَادَ أَن يَبْطِشَ بِالَّذِي هُوَ عَدُوٌ لَهُمَا.
When Musa alayhi salam wanted to go forth in order to deal with the crisis in a similar manner,
قَالَ يَا مُوسَى أَتُرِيدُ أَن تَقْتُلَنِي كَمَا قَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا بِالْأَمْسِ.
This man says, oh Moses, oh Musa, you want to kill me in a similar manner that you killed that man yesterday. Now everybody heard.
And the news is out there, and the soldiers now are looking for Musa alayhi salam. One of the Egyptians who used to love Musa, like Musa, and is one of the close ones to the Pharaoh, he heard that the soldiers are out there to take Musa and capture him and lock him up and make him pay a big price for his crime. He came to Musa looking for him.
وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ يَسْعَى.
A man from the inner part of the city came running to Musa alayhi salam.
يَا مُوسَى إِنَّ الْمَلَأَ يَأْتَمِرُونَ بِكَ لِيَقْتُلُوكَ فَخْرُجْ.
Oh Moses, oh Musa alayhi salam, the chiefs, they are planning against you now in order to kill you. So please leave this city now.
إِنِّي لَكَ مِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ.
I am definitely someone who's genuine. I have a genuine feeling for you.
فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا يَتَرَقَّبَ قَالَ رَبِّ نَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ.
He went out with fear, scared, looking around. Is there anyone following him? Ya Allah, save me from these people. He went east towards Madian. Madian is the city of Shu'aib alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam went to the city of Madian after Allah Azza wa Jal had destroyed the people of Madian. Musa alayhi salam traveling, and we're talking about in hundreds of kilometers, walking with his shoes, that his shoes at the end worn out, and he was walking barefoot. And alayhi salam had no food. What is he going to get from the desert except the leaves that are lying around? It's been mentioned that Musa alayhi salam was eating the leaves of the trees that his lips became green.
When he faced Madian, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide him, praying that, Ya Allah, guide me to the path. Guide me towards some goodness on this path.
Until he arrived to Madian, very skinny, very tired, barefooted, looks like someone who is a miskin, a poor man, that's coming from nowhere to the city of Madian.
وَلَمَّا وَرَدَ مَاءَ مَدْيَنَ وَجَدَ عَلَيْهِ أُمَّةً مِّنَ النَّاسِ يَسْقُونَ.
When he got to the place where they used to make their flocks drink from, it's seen everyone is making their flock drink water.
وَوَجَدَ مِن دُونِهِمُ امْرَأَتَيْنِ تَذُودَانِ قَالَ مَا خَطُبُكُمَا.
He saw two women as well. From all the men who were making their sheep drink. And those women, they were at the back. They were not in the rush of all the men. So he asked them, what is it with the two of you?
قَالَتَا لَا نَسْقِي حَتَّى يُصْدِرَ الرِّعَاءُ وَأَبُؤُنَا شَيْخٌ كَبِيرٌ.
They said, look, we are not going to go and let our sheep drink or our flock drink until these people go back. And our father is an elderly man. He went, he got some buckets of water, and he let all this flock drink, all of them. He did it himself.
فَسَقَى لَهُمَا ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الظِّلِّ فَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ.
He had made this flock drink of the two women, and then he reclined in the shade and he made a dua to Allah saying, "Oh Allah, I am in need of any goodness that you send in my direction."
فَجَاءَتْهُ إِحْدَاهُمَا تَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتِحْيَاءٍ.
One of the two women who were there moments ago, whom he had helped in a very modest way, she's walking back.
إِنَّ أَبِي يَدْعُوكَ لِيَجْزِيَكَ أَجْرَ مَا سَقَيْتَ لَنَا.
My father is calling you in order to give you a reward for what you did for us, in that you made our flock drink. So my father would like to see you. Allahu Akbar. He knew immediately, I made a dua to Allah, there's something now coming in my direction, goodness. So he went. It is said, Allahu A'lam, that he instructed her, "Look, your home, I don't know where it is, but you walk behind me and guide me left or right, and I will walk in front of you." Just so that his eyes did not gaze around here and there. And what happened as a result, she knew this man is very pure, he is honest. Another thing is, he's very, very hard working. It is reported by some of the historians that this man was Shu'aib alayhi salam. Obviously, this is not in the Quran, nor is it in the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But the ulama and the historians from amongst the Muslimin as well are of the opinion, the bulk of them, that this was Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam in Madian.
فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُ وَقَصَّ عَلَيْهِ الْقَصَصِ قَالَ لَا تَخَفْ نَجَوْتَ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ.
So Musa alayhi salam goes there and he narrates the stories. What stories? How he was born and what happened and who Fir'aun is and what he does and what he did and so on and why he had to come. And when he heard the stories, he says, "Don't fear, you've been saved from these oppressors. Don't worry, come."
قالت إحداهما يا أبت استأجره إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين.
One of the young girls tells the father, "Oh my father, why don't you employ him? It is definitely best to employ someone who is strong and honest."
إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى بنتي هاتين على أن تأجرني ثماني حجج فَإِنْ أَتْمَمْتَ عَشْرًا فَمِنْ عِنْدِكَ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَشُقَّ عَلَيْكَ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ.
"Oh Musa, I have a proposal for you. We marry our daughter to you and you pay us the mahar as you work for us 8 years. And if you want to complete those 8 to 10, make it instead of 8, 10, that's up to you. But the minimum that we'll ask for you, from you in return of you marrying our daughter, is to work for us 8 years. I don't want to force this on you. Do you want to complete another 2? That's from you. Inshallah, you'll find me from the righteous. I'm a man of my word. I accept, but this proposal of 8, 10, that's between me and you. If I complete 8, please accept it from me. If I go up to 10, you accept it from me." So they agreed on that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that witnesses what we say. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one we rely on.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give too much detail of how the working went. But what we do know for sure is he was now a shepherd. And he had a flock. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trained him. Through the lips of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every Nabi of Allah has been at some stage a shepherd, where Allah has tested them and trained them through animals, because the amount of patience you need with animals is far more. So now when you are sent to human beings to speak to them, it will be much easier for you to deal with human beings after you've been dealing with animals who couldn't even understand your language.
The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, they asked him, "Oh Messenger of Allah, how many years did Musa alayhi salam do? Did he do the 8 or 10? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said he completed it, and he done the best of it. He completed the 10 years and he done the best of his ability in that 10 years.
So Musa alayhi salam received this training for 10 whole years. And after that, Musa alayhi salatu was salam, he got married. Mashallah, he was very happy. Something within him told him, I need to go back home to see my folks and so on.
فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلَ وَسَارَ بِأَهْلِهِ آنَسَ مِنْ جَانِبِ الطُّورِ نَارًا.
When Musa alayhi salam had finished the time that he had to work for his father-in-law and he wanted to return to Egypt, as he was traveling by night, he'd seen a light on one side of the Mount Tur.
إِذْ رَآ نَارًا فَقَالَ لِأَهْلِهِمْ كُثُوا إِنِّي آنَسْتُ نَارًا لَعَلِّي آتِيكُمْ مِنْهَا بِقَبَسٍ أَوْ أَجِدُ عَلَى النَّارِ هُدًى.
When he had seen this fire, what seemed to him as a fire, a source of light, when he'd seen the light, he paused immediately and told his family, this light I have seen, let me go to it, you wait here, I will come back to you at least with a little piece of it on this cold night. We might have a little bit of warmth and we will come maybe with a log, something that is lit up, or the minimum, if they don't want to share that fire with us, I will at least ask them, where is the road and where is the path? When he got close to that particular light, he noticed something else. As he got closer and closer, it was a bright light. It was not the light of a fire. It was a brighter light than that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how he was addressed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. The words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly to Musa alayhi salam, automatically he received a higher status. He was then known as Kalimullah, the one whom Allah has spoken to directly.
فَلَمَّا أَتَاهَا نُودِيَ يَا مُوسَىٰ إِنِّي أَنَا رَبُّكَ.
When he got close, he heard a call. O Moses, I am your Rabb. I am your maker. I am the one who made you.
فَخْلَعْنَ عَلَيْكَ إِنَّكَ بِالْوَادِ الْمُقَدَّسِ طُوَى.
So remove your shoes. You are indeed in this particular valley of Tuwa, which is very sacred. Immediately he removed his shoes.
وَأَنَا اخْتَرْتُكَ فَاسْتَمِعْ لِمَا يُوحَى.
I have chosen you, O Musa. So listen to what I am revealing to you.
إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري.
The first thing Allah says, indeed I am Allah. There is none worthy of worship besides me alone. So worship me alone and establish your prayer.
إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى.
Indeed, the hour is a reality that is coming. And I have hidden it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. The knowledge of the hour is not known by anybody, so that I can recompense people in the proper manner for their deeds.
وما تلك بيمينك يا موسى.
O Moses, we want to know what is in your right hand. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew this. Allah did not have to ask him that question. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew better than him what was in the right hand. But this is the discussion. Allah, out of the love he had for Musa alayhi salam, is asking him a question. What is that in your right hand? Now Musa alayhi salam, he was now very, very calm, collected, and he was very, very happy that he's speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as him as well, for a long, long time, he was engaged in worshipping Allah alone, according to his forefathers, heading right back to Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam and Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he followed properly the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he recognized that this message is very, very correct. So Musa alayhi salam says,
Hiya asaya,
O my Rabb, this is my stick. It's a stick that I hold.
Atawakka'u alayha,
I lean on it, Ya Allah. I use it as support. Allah didn't ask him, what do you use it for? Allah just said, what is it in your right hand? It was enough for him to say, it's a stick. But he decided, let me now talk a little bit more. When am I going to get this chance again? Subhanallah. وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَىٰ غَنَمِي And I use it in order to help me with my flock so that I can pull down some branches and some, you know, a little bit of the fodder to feed this flock and so on. And I guide the flock with the same stick. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَىٰ And I also use it for many other things, Ya Allah. قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَىٰ فَأَلْقَاهَا فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَىٰ Allah says, we instructed him, throw it, O Musa, throw it down.
When Musa threw that stick turned to become a great massive snake that no human had ever seen in their life.
فَلَمَّا رَآهَا تَهْتَزُّ كَأَنَّهَا جَانٌّ وَلَّا مُدْبِرًا وَلَمْ يُعَقِّبْ يَا مُوسَىٰ أَقْبِلْ وَلَا تَخَفْ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْآمِنِينَ
Allah says, when Musa alayhi salam saw the stick and he'd seen as though it had life in it and it was moving now, he immediately moved back. He wanted to run away. Immediately Allah calls him and says, Ya Musa أَقْبِلْ Oh Musa, come back. Don't fear. You are from amongst the believers.
قَالَ خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَىٰ
O Musa, go back to it and lift it up again. We will make it exactly what it was before. And as he's picking it up, it becomes a stick once again. Subhanallah. Now his iman is strengthened even more.
أُسْلُكْ يَدَكَ فِي جَيْبِكَ تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ
Place your hand at the side of your chest. And Allah says, when you remove it, it will be whiter than ever, without sickness.
And Allah told him, take it out. It took him out. It was glowing like a light. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla told him, oh Musa, put it again. And then he took it out and it came back normal. Those two signs, there are two things that you could use against Fir'aun and his people that are from the fasiqeen, that are from the wrongdoers.
اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى
I am sending you to Fir'aun, for indeed he is a tyrant, he is an oppressor.
قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي
He did not deny it. He says, Oh Allah, clear my chest for me. Cure it for me. Strengthen it for me. And Ya Allah, make my task easy for me. And Ya Allah, my tongue, make it clear. Unknot it. Make it straight and clear so that they can understand what I am saying.
And Musa alayhi salam used to stutter. When he speaks, he stutters in his speech.
قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي قَتَلْتُ مِنْهُمْ نَفْسًا فَأَخَافُ أَن يَقْتُلُونَ
Oh Allah, I killed a man from them. So I fear that they might want to kill me as a result.
وَأَخِي هَارُونُ هُوَ أَفْصَحُ مِنِّي لِسَانًا فَأَرْسِلْهُ مَعِيَ رِدَ أَن يُصَدِّقُنِي إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن يُكَذِّبُونَ
He says, Oh Allah, my brother Harun is much more eloquent than I am. So send him as a prophet with me in order for him to confirm my message. I have a fear that they might belie me. So if you send Harun, he will be more eloquent and he will be able to convey the message in another way where they will be able to understand it even further.
قَالَ سَنَشُدُّ عَضُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ
O Musa alayhi salam, firstly, we have granted you your wish regarding your brother. We will place on your shoulder the strength of your brother as you have requested.
وَنَجَعَلُ لَكُمَا سُلْطَانًا فَلَا يَصِلُونَ إِلَيْكُمَا بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْتُمَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكُمَا الْغَالِبُونَ
We will create an authority for you so they won't be able to harm you. Which means that issue you worried about, the outstanding matter, don't worry. We will create an authority for you. They won't be able to harm you. With our clear signs, inshallah, you will be from amongst the victorious. According to what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who has done the biggest favor upon his own brother was the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. How? He requested that he become a prophet, and as a result he became a Nabi. Subhanallah. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَىٰ. O Musa, we have granted you many gifts. We have blessed you so many times, from the beginning when your mother had to put you down, from the beginning when you were picked up by the family of Fir'aun, from the beginning when this had happened in your upbringing, from the beginning when you had killed someone, we saved you. Then you went to Madian, this happened, that happened. Allah says, we have done you so many favors, Ya Musa. We have indeed favored you. اِذْهَبَا إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ طَغَىٰ. Both of you go to Fir'aun, for indeed he has transgressed beyond limits. فَقُولَا لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَىٰ. Speak to him with soft and kind words, very, very politely, so that he can actually think, he can remember, he can be reminded, and he can be fearful.
They said, oh our Lord, we are scared that once we approach him and stand before him, he'll kill us. Me and him are two people, and this man has a great army. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he respond back to Musa? Don't be afraid. I am with you. I listen and I see. Go, both of you, to Fir'aun and tell him that we are the messengers of our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we command you to send Bani Israel with us. Don't persecute them. You went too way overboard in persecuting and punishing Bani Israel. And we have verses from Allah. We have verses and miracles to show you from Allah. And peace be upon those who follow the right guidance or the right path. Now Musa alayhi salam and Harun will go to Fir'aun. And then the conversation and dialogue starts between him and Fir'aun, in which Musa alayhi salam will start and say, I am the messenger of Allah, coming to guide you to worship no one but Allah.
We want to send you to send Banu Israel with us, and we want you to release them and stop oppression. Fir'aun laughed at them, him and his people.
قَالَ أَلَمْ نُرَبِّكَ فِينَا وَلِيدًا وَلَبِثْتَ فِينَا مِنْ عُمُرِكَ سِنِينَ.
Aren't you the one? Isn't it that we looked after you when you were a little child? We brought you up in our own house. Today you want to be against us. And you stayed for a part of your life with us.
وَفَعَلْتَ فَعْلَتَكَ الَّتِي فَعَلْتَ وَأَنْتَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ.
And you did that little deed of yours which made you run away. And indeed you are from those who are very, very ungrateful.
وَتِلْكَ نِعْمَةٌ تَمُنُّهَا عَلَيَّ أَنْ عَبَّدْتَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ.
He says, you want to come and speak about these favors of yours upon me to try and get away from the fact that you have enslaved the whole of Banu Israel.
قَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ وَمَا رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
You're telling me about رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What is رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ? That is a big insult. You're trying to call him an animal. Astaghfirullah. You say, who is he? Not what is he?
رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا إِن كُنتُم مُقِنِينَ.
Whoever created the skies and the earth and whatever lies between it, if indeed you are convinced, that is who رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ is.
قَالَ لِمَنْ حَوْلَهُ أَلَا تَسْتَمِعُونَ.
He looks at the people around him. He says, are you listening to what this man is saying? Are you listening? Can you hear? Do you know of a God besides me? He is saying there is someone who created the skies and the earth and everyone, and that is the God who deserves to be worshipped alone, nobody else. I am the God.
قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ وَرَبُّ آبَائِكُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ.
He says he is also your God, your maker, the one who made you and your forefathers before you, all of them. He is the maker. We worship him alone. So he says,
إِنَّ رَسُولَكُمُ الَّذِي أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ لَمَجْنُونَ.
Indeed, this messenger who is sent to you is mad. He is mad. Look at him.
Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created the east and the west. You don't have that capability. And people around are just watching. They are shocked. How could someone speak to the Pharaoh like this?
And everybody was gathering, and all the servants and the slaves and the worshippers of Fir'aun are watching someone for the first time in the life of Fir'aun defying him.
لئن اتخذت إلها غيري لأجعلنك من المسجونين.
If you yourself are not going to worship me as a god, I will jail you.
أولو جئتك بشيء مبين.
What if I've brought you something very clear, a sign?
قال فأت به إن كنت من الصادقين.
He says, okay, let's see the sign you have.
فألقى عصاه فإذا هي ثعبان مبين ونزع يده فإذا هي بيضاء للناظرين.
When Fir'aun asked for the sign, let's see it, Musa عليه السلام threw his stick.
And that stick will turn to a massive snake that they mentioned that the tongue of that snake, one part was touching one river, the other was touching the ground. Everyone around sees that scene, gets scared and pulls away. And then Musa grabs it again and it comes back again as a stick.
And he showed them the hand. The hand was white, shining, shining. The people around and Fir'aun together, they said,
إِنَّ هَذَا لَسَاحِرٌ عَلِيمٌ.
This is indeed a very knowledgeable magician. He knows his magic tricks in and out.
قالوا أرجه وأخاه وأرسل في المدائن حاشرين يأتوك بكل ساحر عليم.
Hold himself and his brother and go and send people out, a large number of people out, to call in all the magicians, and we want them to come, let him do this magic and they will do the magic and we see who wins.
And Musa said, okay, put the challenge forward, we accept that challenge. Let's assign a day.
قال موعدكم يوم الزينة وأن يحشر الناس ضحى.
There was an agreement between Musa and Fir'aun to say, we have an appointed day, the day when they would all come in their beauty and all their gold and all their jewelry. On that day in the morning, we will meet inshallah at a specific place. You bring your magicians and we are there.
And now Fir'aun is looking for every magician. And then the day came. Well, people attended the place and it was an open challenge. The people, the Egyptians, Bani Israel, all gathered in a place in which Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun had agreed on. And Musa alayhi salam, along with his brother Harun, will come forward. And Fir'aun will come with his army and his magicians to stand before Musa alayhi salam. And then the challenge will begin, and everyone's watching, and everyone's listening, and everyone is there to experience the great experience of their life.
It's reported that there were 15,000 magicians. And one narration says 70 magicians. So let's take the smaller of the lot. 70 magicians.
قالوا لفرعون أإن لنا لأجرا إن كنا نحن الغالبين.
They looked at Fir'aun and said, well, we want to ask you something before we start here. If we win, what's going to happen? Are we going to get some money?
قال نعم وإنكم إذا لمن المقربين.
Yes, indeed, I'm going to not only give you money, but I will make you my chiefs from amongst my close people.
And then they ask Musa, oh Musa, do you want us to throw our sticks and ropes? Or do you want to throw before?
أَلْقُوا مَا أَنْتُمْ مُلْقُونَ.
Throw whatever you'd like to throw. Let's see it.
فَأَلْقَوْا حِبَالَهُمْ وَعِصِيَّهُمْ.
They threw all their sticks and they threw their ropes and sticks. Whatever they brought with, they just threw it. And then they said,
بِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّا لَنَحْنُ الْغَالِبُونَ.
With this authority of Fir'aun, we will be amongst the winners.
فلما ألقوا سحروا أعين الناس واسترهبوهم وجاءوا بسحر عظيم.
When they threw their ropes and their sticks, they had fiddled with the eyes of the people.
And their sticks and ropes will turn to snakes just floating around everywhere. Everyone got scared, including Musa alayhi salam. He got scared when he saw that scene.
They had created a huge magic. Allah says, imagine if we take the narration of 15,000, there are so many sticks and ropes. What must be happening? The people were worried. Hey, look at all this. What will happen? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
فأوجس في نفسه خيفة موسى.
There was a slight concern in the heart of Musa عليه السلام.
قلنا لا تخف إنك أنت الأعلى وألق ما في يمينك تلقف ما صنعوا إنما صنعوا كيد ساحر ولا يفلح الساحر حيث أتى.
Powerful verses. Allah says, we told him, oh Moses, don't worry. Throw that stick. It will eat everything they have made. It will devour it into non-existence. For indeed what they have brought is magic. The magician will never succeed.
فألقى موسى عصاه فإذا هي تلقف ما يأفكون.
موسى عليه السلام will throw his stick. His stick will turn into a massive snake that ate all the snakes that were around.
And موسى عليه السلام picked it up again. It was a stick.
Who saw that? Not Musa alone, not Fir'aun alone. The magicians and all the people living in Egypt saw that with their own eyes. One man against many. One stick against many. That one snake ate all their snakes. The magicians, they saw Musa. He's not a man of magic. They saw that stick and what that stick turned to. That's not magic.
فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ.
All these magicians fell prostrate.
قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ رَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ.
We believe in the Lord of the worlds, the Lord of Moses and Harun. These two, we are now joining them. We believe that they are worshipping the correct deity. Now Fir'aun is watching. Everybody's watching. They're looking at Fir'aun. How are you going to react? He says,
آمنتم له قبل أن آذن لكم.
How can you believe in him before I give you permission to do that?
إنه لكبيركم الذي علمكم السحر.
This man is actually your senior who taught you all this magic. You're just making a fool of me here.
إن هذا لمكر مكرتموه في المدينة لتخرجوا منها أهلها فسوف تعلمون.
This is just a plan and a plot that all of you have made in order to get Banu Israel out.
لأقطعن أيديكم وأرجلكم من خلاف.
I'm going to cut off your hands and your feet, the opposite. So the right hand with the left foot, the left hand with the right foot, and I'm going to crucify all of you.
اقض ما أنت قاض إنما تقضي هذه الحياة الدنيا.
Do what you want. Pass whatever judgment you want. You can only pass judgment whilst we are in this world.
لا ضير إنا إلى ربنا منقلبون.
No problem. Do what you want to us, Fir'aun. We are definitely going to return to Allah either way. If you kill us or if we die naturally.
إنا نطمع أن يغفر لنا ربنا خطايانا وما أكرهتنا عليه من السحر. والله خير وأبقى.
We are hopeful that our Rabb will forgive our sins and He will forgive the fact that you forced us to engage in this magic here. For indeed Allah is the everlasting and He is much better.
The hands and arms and feet were chopped and they were crucified and they were killed and they passed away to enter the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وقال الملأ من قوم فرعون أتذر موسى وقومه ليفسدوا في الأرض ويذرك وآلهتك قال سنقتل أبناءهم ونستحيي نساءهم وإنا فوقهم قاهرون.
They told themselves and they told Fir'aun, are you going to leave this man doing what he did? He is going to lead people away from your religion, from worshipping you. Fir'aun says, we will slay all of their males and we'll let the females live.
وقال فرعون ذروني أقتل موسى وليدع ربه إني أخاف أن يبدل دينكم أو أن يظهر في الأرض الفساد.
Fir'aun says, let me kill this man. He can call out to his God to save him. I fear that he might change your religion. There was a man One man who was very closely related to Fir'aun in his own household, he had accepted Musa alayhi salam, but no one knew, but he knew.
وقال رجل مؤمن من آل فرعون يكتم إيمانه أتقتلون رجلا أن يقول ربي الله وقد جاءكم بالبينات من ربكم.
There was a man who was a mu'min from the family of Fir'aun who was hiding the fact that he was a mu'min. Do you want to kill a man who is claiming that his God is Allah, the maker, the creator? You want to kill him? How can you want to kill him when he has brought the signs from his Rabb to you to clearly see? If he is a liar, his lies will overtake him. But if he is telling the truth, then you people have had it. So if he is a liar, it's not going to harm you, it's going to harm him. And if he is telling the truth, then you people have had it. Punishment is coming in your direction. So the best thing, don't kill him, leave him. Why do you want to kill him? If you kill him, you are doomed. And if you leave him and he is a liar, he is doomed. So they decided not to kill Musa alayhi salam. These people are being slain one after the other. They need a little bit of encouragement.
قال موسى لقومه استعينوا بالله واصبروا.
Musa alayhi salam instructed his people to do two things. Seek the help of Allah and bear patience.
قالوا أوذينا من قبل أن تأتينا ومن بعد ما جئتنا.
They told him, what's the difference? We have suffered before you came because of you, and we are suffering now after you've come also because of you. Before you came, they used to kill all the children because they didn't want you to be born. Now that you are there and you are up, they're still killing all the children. How can we be behind you?
قال عسى ربكم أن يهلك عدوكم ويستخلفكم في الأرض فينظر كيف تعملون.
He says, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy your enemy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you the leadership on land. You just sit and watch.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start to torture Fir'aun and his people. The first punishment is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Fir'aun and the Egyptians go through a severe drought that are reduced in fruits. The time of season where they used to get hundreds of kilograms of fruits, that season will come, they only get few fruits. This is only the farms of the Egyptians, but the farms and the gardens of Bani Israel, no more fruits. This early drought that will come down to the Egyptians. But Bani Israel, everything is normal.
They went to Moses and said, oh magician, go and call your God to remove this calamity we are in. If he removes it, we are guided. Don't worry, we will accept your message. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Musa alayhi salam made a dua and we removed that. They suddenly broke their promise. So Allah says, we sent them yet another sign. Third sign.
Allah will send the flood on them. A flood will come to them that will destroy all the houses of the Egyptians and the house of Bani Israel untouched.
They went back to Musa alayhi salam. Ya Musa, just call out your God. We will now definitely accept. Musa alayhi salam, when he makes a dua, suddenly everything subsides and returns to normal. And then they laughed at him again. They said, no, it wasn't you, it was us. We sent them. After the third sign, a fourth one. What was the fourth one? We sent them locusts. There were millions and billions of locusts flying around that they covered the sun. It appeared as darkness. And everywhere there were locusts. They sit on locusts, they look at locusts, there's in their food there's locusts, here there's locusts, there there's locusts, a plague of locusts.
And the gardens and the farms of the Bani Israel are left untouched.
And after that they went back to Moses, Musa alayhi salam. Ya Musa, you know what? Call out to your Rabb. So when he calls out, Ya Allah, take this, remove this, it is removed. They went back on their word. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends them yet another sign. The sign of lice all over, biting them, sucking their blood. Everywhere you go, they sleep, they are bitten. They walk, they are bitten. They go to their farms, they are bitten. They come here, they are bitten. They know this is a problem. All of them are bitten. But why are the people with Musa alayhi salam not being bitten? Go and call your God to remove this calamity we are in. If he removes it, we are guided. Don't worry, we will accept your message. And then they laughed at him again. They said, no, it wasn't you, it was us.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send another punishment on them. Allah will send frogs on them. Wherever they go, there's frogs. Frogs in their pillows, in their mattresses, in their toilets, in their food, in their farms, in their houses, in their gatherings. Frogs are just popping out of everywhere. And the people of Israel, they can't even see any frogs around.
They tell Musa alayhi salam, "Ya Musa, we want you to sort this matter out for us. We will definitely believe." Then when Musa alayhi salam made the dua and the sicknesses went, they suddenly broke their promise.
And then the last punishment was the blood. What's this blood? Bani Israel, they were living normal life. But the Egyptians and Pharaoh, when they come to drink water, they fill it up. Once they fill it up, it's normal water. Once it gets filled up, turns to blood. They have normal water, it's just the normal water. They come near it, turns to blood. They come to drink it, turns to blood. They come and have a shower with it, turns to blood. They come to deal or touch this water, turns to blood. And Bani Israel living their normal life. Their water stays normal water. But the Egyptians and Pharaoh, whenever they get near water, the water turns to blood. They drink blood, they have a shower with blood. Their whole life was just revolving around blood.
And after that, they went back to Moses, Musa alayhi salam. "Ya Musa, you know what? Call out to your Rabb." Then when Musa alayhi salam made the dua and the sicknesses went, they went back on their word. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى تِسْعَ آيَاتٍ. Allah says, "We have given Moses 9 signs." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَمَّا وَقَعَ عَلَيْهِمُ الرِّجْزُ قَالُوا يَا مُوسَى ادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ بِمَا عَهِدَ عِنْدَكَ لَإِنْ كَشَفْتَ عَنَّا الرِّجْزَ لَنُؤْمِنَنَّ لَكَ وَلَنُرْسِلَنَّ مَعَكَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ فَلَمَّا كَشَفْنَا عَنْهُمُ الرِّجْزَ إِلَى أَجَلٍ هُمْ بَالِغُوهُ إِذَا هُمْ يَنْكُثُونَ. Every time one of these signs was sent to them, they went to Musa. They said, "Oh Moses, call your Rabb with what he has promised you. Tell him to cure us and to remove this punishment from us and this plague from us. If it is to come out, we will believe in the message and we will release Banu Israel." Then when Musa alayhi salam made the dua and the sicknesses went, they suddenly broke their promise. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Musa alayhi salam and his people, they were suffering a lot at the hands of Fir'aun. He was oppressing them in so many different ways. Musa alayhi salam tells his people, وَقَالَ مُوسَى يَا قَوْمِ إِن كُنتُمْ آمَنْتُمْ بِاللَّهِ فَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنتُمْ مُسْلِمِينَ. Oh my people, if you firmly believe in Allah, now is the time to lay your full trust in Allah if you are submitters. So what did they say? قَالُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا. They said, "We have now laid our trust in Allah." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Fir'aun in the meantime, he's telling his people,
لولا ألقي عليه أسورة من ذهب أو جاء معه الملائكة مقترنين.
You see, the pharaohs, they had lots of jewelry. You know, they had big jewelry even on their heads, gold. He says, "Why doesn't this man have any jewelry at all? Not even one gold bangle. And why doesn't he bring the angels all tied up together, all one serving him? Look at me," Fir'aun is saying. "I have all these people, we tie them and we make them do what we want." You know, the ancient Egyptians, they used to tie the people and make them build their pyramids and what have you and whatever else. Fir'aun is saying, "Why doesn't Moses bring the angels and do the same thing with the angels?" So here, Musa alayhi salam, thereafter, he makes a dua.
وَقَالَ مُوسَى رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ آتَيْتَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَأَهُ زِينَةً وَأَمْوَالًا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا.
Oh Allah, you have given Fir'aun and all his people wealth, so much in this world, and you've given them the beauty of the dunya.
رَبَّنَا لِيُضِلُّوا عَن سَبِيلِكَ.
Oh Allah, have you given them this so that they can lead people astray from your path, Ya Allah?
رَبَّنَا طُمِسْ عَلَىٰ أَمْوَالِهِمْ.
Ya Allah, destroy their wealth totally.
وَاشْدُدَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ.
And Ya Allah, tie their hearts up.
فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى يَرَوُوا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمِ.
Because they will never ever believe until they see severe punishment.
قَالَ قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ دَعْوَتُكُمَا فَاسْتَقِيمَا.
Allahu Akbar. Allah says, the dua of both of you is accepted. Now you just be steadfast. Remain steadfast.
وَلَا تَتَّبِعَانِّ سَبِيلَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ.
Never ever follow the path of those who don't know. The two of you. Who are the two? Musa and Harun. May peace be upon them. So the dua was made by Musa alayhi salam. It is reported Harun alayhi salam was standing next to him saying, Amin, Amin.
وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَسْرِ بِعِبَادِي إِنَّكُمْ مُتَّبَعُونَ
We revealed to Musa alayhi salam, at night, take all Banu Israel and you go towards the sea and you will be followed. So Musa alayhi salam tells the whole of Banu Israel, quietly, at night, we need to go. Everyone, leave everything and let's move. Where do we go? Just go, let's go. So they all went. How many were they? There were 600,000. And as they're gone, Fir'aun gets the news. So Fir'aun says, what? They are going there? We are going to follow them. But he was too lazy to go by night. You see, he had all different mode of transport, much quicker and faster than these people who were busy walking. In the morning, Allah says, فَأَتْبَعُوهُمْ مُشْرِقِينَ Fir'aun and them, they left early morning. They didn't want to travel by night. So Musa alayhi salam is walking with them. And they got to the sea.
Where Musa alayhi salam is standing, trying to figure out which way possible for them to go from one side of the sea to the other side.
And from a distance, the people of Musa who were right at the end, they saw these people of Fir'aun coming in.
And Fir'aun and his army, an army that exceeds 1.5 million soldiers, my brothers and sisters.
فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ
When the two armies, when the two groups saw each other, the people of Musa said, no, we are now caught, we're in trouble. So Musa alayhi salam heard that.
He said, no, absolutely no, Allah will guide me. Don't worry, Allah Azza wa Jalla will guide me.
فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ أَنِ اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرِ
Allah says, we revealed to Musa alayhi salam at that moment, strike the sea with your stick. So he struck it.
فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ
It separated the water so that either side looked like a large mountain. And Allah says it was dry.
And here Musa alayhi salam will walk. And Bani Israel from behind Musa will follow. Walking from one side of the sea to the other side of the sea. Looking towards their right, a mountain of water ready to fall any time. Looking towards their left, another great mountain of water ready to flood them any time.
Now, Fir'aun and his people are wondering what's happening here. But as they got closer, these people were already far inside. They were already starting to come out on the other side.
Once they arrived, they saw that great miracle in front of them. And Musa, alayhi salam, is on the other side with Bani Israel. And then Fir'aun will see that Musa walked through that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the fear in the heart of Fir'aun and his army. But Fir'aun, because of his pride, he thought that he could save himself and go to the other side of the sea like Musa alayhi salam. And Fir'aun will order his army to go inside that path. And then Fir'aun will walk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his hikmah made the whole army walk into the path.
Musa alayhi salam hit it with a stick again to do what? Close it. By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, started closing in.
حَتَّى إِذَا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرَقُ
When he was almost drowning,
قَالَ آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلِ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ
He says, I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship besides the God of Banu Israel and I am a submitter.
أَلْآنَ وَقَدْ عَصَيْتَ قَبْلُ وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ
Is it now that you want to accept this message? Yet you were disobedient in the past and you were from amongst the corrupt. And his body was turning and Banu Israel is looking at this man who called himself God, helplessly tossing, turning on the water and tossing and turning and coming and going and he's drowning and bubbling and so on. Next thing he's gone, totally drowned. And after a while what happens? The earth spat him out. Why was he spat out? Allah says,
فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً وإن كثيرا من الناس عن آياتنا لغافلون.
This day we shall preserve this body of yours for it to be a means of lesson for those who are to follow. And Allah says, but still so many people are oblivious of our signs. Until we meet again. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.